Hi, everybody. How are you today? I'm going to give Face Minute a minute to build me a live audience because that's what they keep telling me they're going to do. So, so I'm going to sit here for a minute, turn my music down because apparently you cannot listen to music on Facebook unless it's unless it's on the artist page. I don't know how that works, but apparently it's a bad thing and you're not allowed to do it anymore. So, okay, that's what we're going to do. All right, so you guys might know I've been sick for the last few days. So my nose is really irritated, really bad. Thankfully, it's not super visible. So that's a good thing. First thing I'm going to do is pick my eyes. First thing I'm going to do is put my primer on. I got to grab it. Totally forgot my primer. How did that happen? Okay. Sorry about that. I feel foolish now. Okay. So first thing I'm going to do is put on my primer. It is Glorious Face and Eye Primer. Put it on every day, every time I'm going to wear makeup. The reason, again, is that it helps your makeup to not be absorbed down into your pores, to help your makeup blend better, help it last longer on your face during the day, and it helps extend the life of your products because you use less product to get the same look. I hope that makes sense. And yeah, my eyes are super dark today. I had almost no sleep. Not that that's a real big deal because I generally don't get a lot of sleep, but last night was a really small amount of sleep. So, today's look, not really sure yet. I kind of had a plan, but I think that plan is over. Yeah, pretty sure. So, it says my connection is weak. I hope I don't lose you. I really don't. So how about we go grab some makeup? I'm going to take you with me. This doesn't usually happen. This is my bedroom. So you can look in my makeup drawer here with me. Let's see. Look, there's all my addiction palettes. I'm going to flip this because that's easier. Did I just go back? Oh, there we go. There you go. So you can now look at what I'm looking at. I'm going to grab my addiction palettes. Those are my pigments. This is how I keep all of my makeup on my makeup desk. This is my laundry, dirty laundry. I'm sure y'all are familiar with that. This is my goals, and this is where I sit, and I love that phrase. The more you praise and celebrate your life, the more there is in life to be celebrated. My wedding picture. I just think it's nice. So I think what I will do, anybody have any ideas? Hi, Kayla. What kind of look should I do today? I was waiting for Facebook to build me an audience, and I have some stuff in here that I really don't, honestly, I don't feel like doing right now, because I don't. So, if anybody has any idea, I'm going to put my stuff back. Yes, I keep my stuff really organized. I keep my stuff really organized. I don't like chaos. Especially in my makeup. I do not like chaos at all. So, what are we going to do here? This is the first time I've done a video and did not have all my ducks in a row. Usually I have everything really planned out. But this is life. And this is what happens when we live. Things happen. So, what are we going to do? Hi, Holly. What look are we going to do today? I'm trying to figure it out. I got all this stuff. My pigments here. I have, I also do have the Urban Decay through the Looking Glass palette. Let's see. What do I want to do today? Maybe I'll try. Maybe I'm going to try a, I think I'll add some darker colors today. Because I don't do it a whole lot. There's my backyard. See, that's what I look at. Still says my connection is weak, so hopefully you guys don't go anywhere. Yeah. Grab some bronzer. What else are we gonna grab here? Look at my fingers. Give me ideas. I'm sucking the ideas out of your brain right now. Brain. Give me your brain. Okay. I just grabbed the big tray of brushes. And I'm just going to have at it. All right. So, I already have my primer on. Shut my air conditioning vents so I'm not getting cold air blown up into my face the whole time. So, I have my primer on. I'm going to go ahead and put on my liquid foundation. And I'm going to grab my other concealer. Oh, I didn't even have to get up. I'm going to grab the one shade darker concealer. This is the shade Scarlet in my Mineral Touch Liquid Foundation. And this is the shade Velour in my Mineral Touch Skin Perfecting Concealer. Now, Velour has yellow undertones. So that is for people that have yellow undertones. Scarlet is a neutral. This is also the lightest shade that we have. Organza is the lightest pink toned shade that we have, and then they build up from there. Let's see. I think I'm just gonna do my basic foundation that I do every day. Hi, Holly. So what I'm gonna do is 3 drops of liquid foundation. I'm gonna watch. 1, 2, 3. 3 drops of liquid foundation. And I'm mixing the second color in to make it a little bit darker because over the summer I've gotten a little darker, so my makeup is going to get a little darker. So just a, I'm going to squeeze a little bit more because it doesn't want to come out. It's pretty thick. I mean, honestly, it's a thick concealer, and that's good because it's not thick and sticky or thick and cakey. It's thick and it spreads very well. It spreads without feeling like you have smeared makeup on your face. Does that make sense? Hi, Simone. Hi, Melinda. So I'm going to dot this all over my face. So 3 dots of liquid concealer, 1 dot or liquid foundation, 1 dot of concealer. And see that dark? You can see the difference in the tone. And then I'm going to blend them over my whole face. I'm going to be careful around my nose today. I've been sick for the last couple days. So, because I'm blowing my nose, like, 300 times a day. Literally, I've gone through like 4 boxes of Kleenex since last weekend. So I have really dry, kind of flaky stuff on the end of my nose. You know how you get when you got a bad cold. We all do. Anyway. It's really not been very bad because, ooh, this light makes me look like I just totally changed skin color. That's crazy, right? Well, that's not too bad now that we're blending it. Anyway, my Divine Daily Moisture that I put on every single day, which is moisturizer, as you might have been able to guess, it has really helped to keep the flakiness down right on the ends of my nostrils. The flakiness has been diminished a lot more than it normally is. And then, of course, I fell back to the old granny rule. Smear some Vaseline on it before you go to bed. Smear some Vaseline on. It's good for your skin. It really is. Vaseline is, like, amazing. And Vicks. I didn't do Vicks because that would have burned with flaky stuff. So, no Vicks. But, you know, Grandma told you to slather Crisco on your face, and it'd probably work. I mean, it's probably pretty gross, but it'll work. Just saying. Oh, I'm sorry, Simone. No, I'm not using BB cream. I'm using the liquid foundation, and I'm using my liquid foundation brush. So I don't know if BB, you meant the BB cream. I'm not using that today. But the BB, if you're meaning beauty blender, I'm also not using that today because I generally just use that with my BB cream because of the consistency. And because this liquid foundation brush has the little divot in the middle, and the bristles are such that they create... See how it doesn't look like, you don't see brush marks in my skin. Is that a good description? Does that help? There's no brush marks left behind by this brush. So I really enjoy using this brush to apply my foundation. I get the most coverage out of the least amount of product. I did do a video yesterday though with BB cream, and if you didn't get to see it, I will post it again. All right? That brush is amazing. Hey, Carrie. Thank you, Melinda. Yeah, the brush is amazing. I love the liquid foundation brush. It's probably my absolute favorite piece. Absolute favorite tool as well. Thank you, Simone. Am I saying your name right? I hope I am. I feel like I just want to make sure I'm saying it right. So, let's see. What else am I going to do now? I'm not used to having it in I have a big box today with all my stuff in it. And usually I just have it in all these little containers with, like, face, eyes, all separated so I can just grab it one at a time. Next. Let's see. What will I do next? Maybe I'm going to go ahead and work on my brows next. I like to get them out of the way pretty early. Some people wait until last. I like to do it early because I just like to look at my brows. Good. Oh, I'm so glad I'm saying it right. I know Holly can relate, my daughter, and several other people whose last names I will not even attempt. We have last names as well as first names that are, some people just cannot say properly. My daughter's name is Cheyenne, but her full name is Cheyenne Kaprowitz, and it's spelled really long. Holly's is the same. Mine used to be that. You try to explain how to say that to people when they read it. It's a hard time. I'm telling you right now, it's a hard time. So I'm going to use I have the Anastasia auburn colored eyebrow pencil. I really like this pencil. I like the color. I like the consistency. I do want to reorder my light shade unique brow pencil. I just have not ordered it yet. Why? Because I'm lazy. So there you go. No, it's not because I'm lazy. It's because I've been working so hard. I hope that some of you ladies that are having beauty bashes with my friends are here right now. Because I love making new friends. I love when everybody can come over here and see something live. And then we can go back to the beauty bash and we can talk about it. See what everybody likes. Now I'm going to clean up this lower edge with my concealer here in just a minute. So I'm not too worried. And you saw I brushed it first in the shape that I wanted to get. And I'm just going inside of this lower line just to make it a little more distinct, a little more clear. I'm just like copying the tail over there. Do the same thing here. I try to stay inside of my brow line, kind of going in between hairs and making little lines. It's a whole lot of the use of the word line. So inside my brows. I'm gonna move that around a little bit. And this is why you clean up the edges afterwards, because you manipulate it and you want it to look like real hair. You don't want just straight lines across your forehead in pencil. Nobody really wants that. I know you don't. Okay, so that's it. That's all I'm going to do on my brow. I lost my concealer. That's okay. Not worried about it. I've been doing a lot of impromptu, terrible singing lately. So, y'all are just going to have to deal with it. I did find my concealer. I was wrong. So, I'm using the Skin Perfecting Concealer. This is in Scarlet. The other one that I used was in Velour, so I want a shade darker for my overall look. This is my regular shade, but it is lighter than what I am today, so this will give a highlight, okay? And I'll show you real quick the top line before I highlight. See the top line of my brow? Take your foundation brush. You want the top brow to match your foundation. The underneath can be brighter, can be lighter, can be highlighted. The top should match. So I'm just going to trace that line at the top. And just clean it up. That's it. That's all I'm doing. Now I'm going to tap in my concealer brush. I already did. I'm going to take some of that off. That's a lot. I'm just going to go on this bottom line. And just clean up that bottom edge, and it also brightens. That's right, I have little hairs up there. So do you. And y'all, don't be so critical. When you're looking in the mirror and you're sitting this close doing your makeup and you see that a line's not perfect. This is how it looks when you're really close. And this is how it looks to everybody else. Not quite so drastic of a light change, but that's how it looks to everybody else. Back up. Take a look at how good you look. All right, so I have a little bit of concealer left on my hand. I'm just going to take it right here. I just want to brighten up that inner corner today because I didn't sleep much. I feel like that's where it's the most visible. I'm going to take my finger and just blend that out. Much better. I feel much better. Oh, thank you, Simone. To finish my brows, I'm going to use a little bit of hairspray because I ran out of gel. So a nice clear gel for your brows, and gel basically usually colors and it keeps your brows in place. Wax will do the same thing. I use a clean mascara wand, spray it with hairspray, lightly, let it dry just a little bit, shake it, and then I trace over my brow line. And then my brows stay right in place all day long. Obviously, I do prefer my brow gel. But again, I need to order my brow gel and my brow liner. We have a kit. That's the way I'm ordering it. It's both pieces together. I just haven't ordered it yet. I've been so busy putting all of your orders in, haven't had time to put in mine. But I'm totally and absolutely obsessively grateful for every one of your orders. I truly appreciate it. Okay, so what's next? What are we going to do next here? Let's do some bronzer real quick, just because I feel like I took away all the shape of my face when I made everything one color. That's just how I feel about it. So I'm just going to go in here, taking this little e.l.f. fluffy, not quite a blush brush, tap, 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 suck in. Blend in a little bit of a circle, wider here, narrower here. You want the shape that way. Okay. I'm going to take a little bit on my forehead too, right here. Whoop. Just in, right here, like a windshield wiper. I'm not bothering with my nose. I'll bother right here. And I just tapped it in a little bit. I'm really applying and blending at the same time because I'm not doing a strong contour. So now I'm going to take my blush. I almost always wear blush with my contour, with my beachfront bronzer, because I enjoy having a little bit of color other than a tan color, which is what the bronzer gives you, as a tan glowing color. I also like to have the pretty pink color. This is the Moodstruck Minerals Pressed Blusher. This is in the shade Stunning. It's personally my favorite. I believe we have 8 shades. They range in everything from corals and pinks to a red. They're beautiful. Highly pigmented. I've been using this one for months and months, like February. Yeah. Dip, dip. I'm going to blow some of that off. It's a lot. At the back, right over, there's my bronzer. Here's my blusher. Right over and slightly above. I love to get the apples of my cheeks. That's it for blusher and bronzer. That's all. I feel like it gives me a little more depth to my face again. I feel a little more alive. That's why I use it. And I feel like I look pretty when I have blush on. I'm sure many of you feel the same way. Another drink. Hi, Garrett. Thanks for joining us. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is some eyeshadow. I think I'm going to play with palette 3. I've really been using this a lot lately. It's purple. So I think today I'm going to try... let's do a lighter one. I said I was going to go super dark, but I think I'm going to go light right in here. These colors are Flippant, Smitten, Determined. This is Tickled. Oh, can you see that? Yeah. There we go. That's a good one. Tickled, Ecstatic, Determined, Smitten, Flippant, Cheeky, and Irate. Lovely, right? Absolutely love. I love the names of all of our makeup colors. Oh, you know what? I'm not. I did have a specific eyeshadow I wanted to do today. Now I just lost the brush again. Y'all, I'm like out of it today. I must have took too much Sudafed this morning. For real. For real. I am going to do a neutral eye. I haven't done one in a while. So I'm going to use palette one. Probably the most versatile palette we have because it is neutral. So it's good for all skin tones. You can do everything from day looks to smoky night looks to everything in between with it. Great, great palette. Great palette. The colors we have here are Zealous, Forthright, Swanky, Chipper, Brassy, and Sincere, as well as Elated, which happens to be almost a skin tone for me. I'm going to start with that. I'm going to use this little round brush. It's got pretty stiff bristles so that I can get color everywhere. And I'm going to use that skin tone, Elated. Sorry, it's a skin tone for me. Elated. And I'm going to take this literally from brow to lash line. Brow to lash line. I'm going to do it in circles. I'm even taking it down here. Because this will be a really great way to blend further colors is by putting this base color everywhere. And all these colors are blendable, they're buildable, they're lovely. We're just going to keep filling this in. Okay, so that's the color Elated. I already took that all over. Now, I'm going to go in, just grab my big handful of eye brushes here. Lay them out so I can decide what I'm going to use. I believe I will go in with this brush. This is a little flatter. It's a crease brush. It's a little longer than my other crease brush, but I really like it. It does a great job. I need to make sure it's clean. So I rub it here just to make sure it's clean for the new color. I need to clean my brushes. Okay, so I'm going to go in with... What will we do? We're going to do Chipper next. Right here. And I'm going to load this up on the brush. And I'm going to do my crease. So, I'm doing my crease. With Chipper. I'm going to add a little more. I'm going to blend that up in a circle. I'm going to take a different brush and blend it. I'll just get this on there. I'm going to use a fluffier brush. This big fluffy kind of bullet shaped brush in a circle. Blend this up onto the upper crease. The hood, so to speak. I'm gonna add a little more right here because I noticed the color is a little lower right there. And I'm going to blend again. There we go. And I'll show you how to clean it up at the end. Okay? Actually, I don't know if I have tape right here. I'll show you a tape trick. Ah, we do. Ooh, trick time. Gotcha. Here we go. Scotch tape. See it, know it, love it, own it. Everybody does. You put it on your face. Yeah. I'm gonna take this. I'm going to point it up a little more today. How do you like that? Did you think I was going to be giving myself a facelift today? Well, I am. Hi, Joelle. Doing instant facelifts today. That's what we're doing. Come over, grab you a piece of this. Okay, so I am going to blend this brown everywhere. The brown is chipper. I'm gonna go back to this crease brush again. I'm gonna go in on the other side. I'm gonna fill that crease. I may attempt a cut crease. Why not? Right? Why not? Now I'm going to blend. Again, I went with the bullet-shaped, fluffier brush to blend. No harsh lines. We're going to add more over here because I went way higher on the other side. And that's the beauty of makeup. You can build, you can build, you can build. You can keep adding it. Now, if you put too much on, it's kind of hard to take it away. But you can build. And these colors are buildable. They're soft. It's buttery. Do the windshield wiper. Okay, so that's it for chipper for now. Next color I'm going to do will be Swanky. Let's do Swanky. Oh, you know what? I was wrong again. We're going to go in with Forthright, which is right here, this super dark color. Now, I want a pretty tight brush for this. I'll use this one. This is actually a lip brush. It's by Flower. Picked it up at Walmart. But I'm going to dip the brush into Forthright here. And I'm going to trace my crease. Okay. Now, when I blend this, I'm going to use a very small crease brush that I have because I'm just going to blend in my crease. Okay. Hi, Kurt. Hi, Crystal. So I'm going to go back in and do this on the other side. Forthright in the crease. And then again, that very tight blending brush, windshield wiper. So how's everybody doing today? How's everybody doing today? I hope you're doing great. It is Monday. Kids started school here today. I'm just adding a little bit more of this dark shade. Okay. So, what am I gonna do next? I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm going to try a YouTube trick that I saw. You ready for this? YouTube tricks. YouTube tricks with Rosie. I'm going to take my concealer. The shade Scarlet. Wonder if I should do my powder. We'll do liquid. I'm going to put this on the back of my hand. Right, Crystal? It's Monday. The kids are in school. What's better? Right? What's better? All right. I'm going to take my concealer brush. I'm going to tap into this lightly. I'm going to trace my lid. We're gonna let that set for a second. I'm not usually like, let it sit. I usually don't say that, but I feel like this needs to sit a little bit, especially since I didn't get anything to blot a powder with. Now when you watch this on YouTube, it's like, shh, and then they're, hey, look at my beautiful eyes. It doesn't happen like that. That's not reality. But here's something that is reality. I have concealer powder as well, and I have a dry little concealer brush. Boop. Oop, I dropped one. And I'm going to take and pat this over that. I'm going to pat it off on my hand a little. See, I just have some in the lid. Pat it off on my hand a little. I am using this basically as a setting powder. I'm afraid to open my eye. Oh, okay. See that cut crease? It'll get better in a minute. It won't look quite so drastic. Just give it a minute. Okay. You guys are learning with me. So, we're going to go in over here with the liquid concealer. Now, this look today, this is not your 5-minute mom out the door look. This is your... Hey, honey, we're going out. It's our anniversary. Let's Let's get dolled up. I'll be ready in an hour. And if your line is not perfect, don't worry. Nothing is perfect. We'll get it later. Yeah, I'm still here. Tap over with my powder. Now that's, look, totally different lines. Totally different lines. Told you you were learning with me. But I'll fix it. Don't worry. So I have two choices. I can either make both my lids look exceptionally huge and go up a little bit on this one, or I can go back over it with the brown. And what I'm gonna choose to do is go back over it with the brown. I'm going to just hit it with forthright. Ooh, that's a lot darker. That's much better, right? Much better? I hope so. Because I'm going with it. Okay, so. Now what will I do? I'm going to go in with my favorite color because my favorite color in this palette makes everything better in my whole life. Okay? Everything. It makes everything better in my whole life. Are you ready? My favorite color in this whole palette is brassy. Right there. It's so beautiful. Everything is better. So I'm going to hit with this slightly flat, slightly big brush here, and I'm going to tap it right over that concealer. I'm totally happy with it. I will be, I am going to go over this just a little, lower that line a little. So that's the thing with the cut crease, it needs to be really clean. Really clean. And then you kind of have to smudge it up a little bit. Much better. All right. So, now I'm going to do a winged eyeliner. Yeah, wings. I'm going to do wings. Wings with pencils. Look. Did you guys see that? I totally had concealer on the palm of my hand. And I just dotted it over my face. I'll probably find concealer dots everywhere later. This should be great. I have makeup all over my hands. Hi, Katarina. Hi, Kristen. Hi, Holly. All right. So now I'm going to do a wing with my pencil. And I'm going to start at the outside. I'm going to go all the way to this where I did my cut crease. A little past it, actually. I
That's tape you hear being hit with a pencil. Opening as I go in, okay? I start closed. Ooh. I'm just building that line up. Are my wings perfect? No. Do I care? No. They're mine. And I taped this one totally off, so I didn't even have tape. I'm just gonna fatten it up right here at the corner and bring it down. Everybody's makeup isn't perfect every day. Just put it on. That's all you have to do. Just put it on. That's it. My husband is outside making faces, which is pretty funny. All right, now, what else am I gonna do? Hey, oh, thank you, Katarina. Hi, everybody. What else can I add? I just wanna add some more stuff, I love it. All right, I'm gonna use my cream shadow brush, and I am going to go in at that crease line with Swanky, because it is shiny and bright. Swanky is right here. It's really hard, there we go. That's Swanky. It's kind of a rose gold, maybe? It's not rose gold. There's no pink in it. But it's a little darker. I think it'll help bring that together a little bit more. And I'm gonna bring it right here under this cat eye. And blend. And under. And blend. I'm going to take Sincere, which is right here. I'm going to kind of load up on that. And I'm going to tap that right in this inner corner. I'm going to use the same color, Sincere, right here as a highlight on the brow. Okay. Now, what's left? Oh, I'll do my lips. Then I'll do my mascara. Sound good? All right. That's what we're going to do. I'm going to use my Posh lip liner because I did choose red today, so it's going to be red. Don't care. You can't go wrong with a red lip. You just can't. This is in the color Excessive. I'll save that. I'm going to fill in my lips. Oh, sorry, my nose ring. Oh. I'm going to line them because I forgot to sharpen. I forgot to sharpen my pencil. I will line though. I am 40. I do get dehydrated a lot. I'm actually 41. I do get dehydrated a lot, so I end up with little lines like escaping, bleeding on my lips. You know what I mean? The color bleeds. There's more concealer. And more. Lots of concealer spots today. Anyway, the bleeding of the lip products up onto your face can be stopped with lip liner. That's what you use it for. Fill this back in. These are just little touches. I'm going to go in my waterline. Because why not? I think it adds a lot of depth to the black. And helps distribute it right at your lash line. Okay? That's really what happens to it. It gets distributed into your lash line. I don't have anything to wipe this concealer off with. One second. Okay. That's where all the concealer was coming from, was the back of my hand where I put it. Good job, right? Everybody, yay, Rosie. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is my 3D Fiber lashes. Probably just going to do gel because it's going to be really hard to see lashes with this much cat eye. I mean, let's just be honest here. And I don't have any giant falsies. Because really, that's how most of those girls on Instagram get that look. A lot of makeup artists only use falsies. Why? Because it's fast and it's easy. Not that this isn't, because I think it is. I'm going to go ahead and do fibers. I have to. And just roll it on the back of my hand. This is the fibers. And we just talked about this yesterday. Gel, fibers, gel. Okay? While I'm waiting for that one to dry and set, I will do this one. Now, this one is ready for the gel again to seal the fibers in place for the whole day. So, did I tell you guys I have a YouTube channel? I do. I have a YouTube channel. You can find it by searching Little Frog 75 on YouTube. And then you'll see beautiful Rosie and the videos that I upload. Most of the videos I'm doing live, I'm trying to move over to YouTube so that you can view them at your leisure, which is nice because, you know, I may not always be doing this look on the day when you're going to need to go out. So you'll be able to refer to it. I'm going to do my bottom. Universal mascara face. Right, ladies? Yeah. It's funny. Making mascara face is kind of like turning down the radio when you're driving so you can get there. We all do it. All right. Last piece of this puzzle today, y'all. I know I've been putting a whole lot of stuff on my face today. The last piece of this puzzle is going to be my Opulence lipstick. This is in the shade Excessive. I love it. I love this shade. Oh. I'm going to do something that I usually do off camera. Okay, here's a secret for you guys. I usually do set my face. I use a mist and set. Rose water is excellent. I don't have any right now. So I went to Walmart and I got a bottle of this e.l.f. mist and set. I believe it was $3. And it works really well. So all you do is you open up the bottle, you spray your whole face. Now, this is a great time to take your beauty blender, damp beauty blender, and press this setting spray into your face, and it will help to make your face have a more airbrushed finish. Thank you, Amanda, for suggesting the beauty blender. I will be getting one. And Amanda knows exactly who I'm talking to. I believe your last name is Cusiewicz. But I hope I didn't just butcher that. All right, so the last piece of this puzzle today is this. Oh, yeah. Red. Red, red, red. I love it.